just the case, it's all right.
Yeah, I don't know.
many of you are familiar with traditional Irish music. This band was formed about 5 years ago in Kansas City, and they played part-time for about 2 or 3 years. They've appeared down at Silver Dollar City for the last 2 years, and will start down there again in May 15th, I think, for another 2 weeks set. Traditional Irish music has gone through a number of changes in the last, I'd say, 25 years. The introduction of a lot of unusual instruments, which you will see on stage. One of these is this long-necked member of the mandolin family. It's actually called by a number of names. Cittern is one word that's used. Bouzouki is another. It's actually an octave mandolin with a few changes to it. We do use the traditional instruments, which you will hear tonight, which will be the uilleann bagpipes, the elbow pipes. You will note that he doesn't blow into it. He uses a bellows under his right arm, and the bag is under his left arm. Plays the chanter with his fingers. And, of course, such traditional instruments as the tenor banjo, which has been a part of Irish music for over 100 years, and the fiddle and the flute. And I think you will enjoy this, because what these folks are doing with the music is bringing it into the 20th century and adding some things that we think make it very modern. I introduce to you Scartaglen.
Thank you. started off with a slide and three polkas. And I won't bother you with the names of those. And the second set of tunes we played was an air called The Ferry Boy, and a reel that Kirk wrote and named after his father called D.G. Lynch's reel.
I was supposed to sing a song a cappella, but I have the farm report coming out of my amplifier over here. If you don't want to know the price of pork bellies, just talk to me afterwards. This song is about a young man who decides to leave his sweetheart for another woman. He does this because his new lady is fair, and if you know anything about the British ballad tradition, you know that to be fair means that you probably also had lily white hands and skin as white as milk, which to me sounds like grubs and night crawlers, but aesthetics aside, it's safe to assume also if you possess these qualities, you probably belong to the privileged classes. So it's safe to assume that lady number two probably has a lot of money, or someone in her family does. So thus, lady number one is passed over, and she doesn't take this very well. Rather than languishing and sighing and sobbing and making moans like people in ballads tend to do, she decides to take revenge. So this is a song called The Brown Girl.
I am as brown as brown can be, and me eyes are black as snows. I am as brisk as nightingale, and wild as a forest doe. My love, he is so high and proud, his fortune too so saying his love I valued not, whether he would fancy me or whether he would not. When that 6 months were gone and past, were over, gone and past, then did my love once so bold grow sick with love at last. When the 6 months were past and gone, were over, past and gone, then did my love once so bold lie on his bed and moan. Oh, first he sent for the doctor man. You doctor must me cure these pains that now do torture me. I cannot long endure. But ne'er went the doctor man, his suffering could relieve. Oh, ne'er a one but the brown, brown girl who could his life. From out the town, oh, then he sent for thank you.
In 1968, when I graduated from high school, I had a draft number of 6. So I thought it wise to join the Navy. I did so on my lunch hour. I was working at a clothing store as a stock clerk, and I came home that evening and told my folks. Both of them were a little surprised, to say the least. Anyway, 30 days later, after physicals and all that stuff that they do, I was at the airport standing here waiting for the plane to go, and my mom is crying her heart out. My dad is a face of stone. And I thought, well, he really is glad that the grocery bill is going down. And that the hot water will be in the hot water heater and it won't be all used up by yours truly. Anyway, so 4 years, I got out. 2 years later, I asked him. Well, what was it? I mean, were you really glad to see the Oasis? No, Mike. I just don't show my feelings like your mother. And it occurred to me when I found the words for this song, actually I wrote a good number of them, that there are a lot of fellas out there who don't show their feelings to the people they love and care about as much as anyone else. It's just their faces are there. You can't read them. So this song's for you. It's about a father who worries for his son who's in battle.
Irish dance tunes preceded by a piece of Hebridean mouth music Knot music is sort of dance music that is sung or lilted, generally nonsensical words in Gaelic. These particular words come from the Hebridean Islands off of the western coast of Scotland. The song is called Shudabalaga. If you know it, you're welcome to mumble along with us. Anyway, we'll go from that into a tune called Jenny's Chickens, and that will be followed by a reel called The Boys of the Loch.
Heat is absolute death to a reed. As Kirk will attest. And it doesn't quit playing, it just changes key.
And doesn't bother to tell anyone that it's going to do that.
Oh. In the halftime, if you see any instruments up here you want to know anything about, like Dave prefaced a little bit of that, you know, at the beginning, feel free to come up and ask us. We'll be glad to talk to you about, especially those weird things Kirk's playing.
What weird
things?
Michael's going to sing a song for you now.
In 1864, I believe it was, there was a battle. In the Civil War, it's called Battle of Shiloh. And I found these words in a poetry book of American poetry. The author of this was anonymous. And the words talk of a young boy who was killed in battle, the Battle of Shiloh. So, curious as I am, I went down to the library and looked up some information on the Battle of Shiloh. And it turns out that a lot of young boys between the ages of 9 and 15 died in that battle, who were litter bearers, drummer boys, as the song is about, and message runners. So, just like all war songs sort of says, it's about time we stop doing it. It's hazardous to your health.
Thank you. I'm going to do set of tunes before we take a little break. This is a set of four reels. This is on our second album, which you can indeed purchase right here. So during the break, we hope you all buy records and you're all broke by the end of the break.
Thank you.
side of that album that some of you bought. There's a song called The Broken Down Squatter. And it's about an economic depression that occurred in Australia sometime between 1865 and 1870. I think it was 1868. He's a little guy, tenant farmer. Rents the land, sells what he grows. And of course, the little guy, as we all know, is the one that gets that done first when everybody's declaring bankruptcy and jumping out of windows and that kind of thing. So this is a little odd in that he's singing this song to his horse as he rides away from his home, the home of his birth. His horse's name is Stumpy. When I first heard the name of the horse, I thought he's actually riding a dachshund, you know, like a horse with 2.5 foot legs across the prairie of Australia. But we thought about renaming the horse. Trigger was mentioned. But we thought that if the Australians, if we ever played in Australia, we'd have to sing Stumpy. So we thought, well, we'll just leave it the way it is because that's the way they wrote it. So it's called Broken Down Squatter.
The river for fats. horse spiel on the 50-mile plain, or rip out the scrub by the line of the moon, or see the old stockyards again. Leave the slip panels down, it don't matter much now. There are none but the crows left to see, perching gaunt on yon pine, as though longing to dine on a broken down squatter like me. And the banks are all broken, they say, and the merchants are all up a tree. When the bigwigs are brought to the bankruptcy court, what chance for a squatter like me? What chance for a squatter like me?
Southwest of Ireland. These are also on our second album, The Middle Path. For those of you who have bought it, we thank you.
Yes, have we mentioned that we have an album for sale? It's about a girl and a sailor. That's all we'll say about that. The song sort of explains itself. This is a song called Rosemary Lane. Soybeans are doing well, by the way, if anybody's interested.
Jigs now. These are something of an adventure for us. If you hear anything weird in the first tune, it's supposed to be that way. At one point, there's actually two different tunes going on at two different keys at the same time. We like it.
Besides, we couldn't decide which one to do, so we're doing them both.
The reason Scartaglen exists is because Kirk can't play all the instruments at once. Yes. That's the whole truth. He was a one-man band star in New York City on Fifth Avenue for many, many years.
One, two, three, four.
Thanks, that was, folks, that was so fast. I believe I'm going to have to rest a minute to catch up here.
We're going to slow the pace down a little bit with a slow tune, a waltz tune called Metal Man. It's written by a fellow named Barry Dramsfield, and he wrote it after a lighthouse off the coast of County Cork, which presumably is made of metal. I don't know, I've never seen it myself. Sea Shanty was written by a fellow named Peter Bellamy. He's an Englishman. We met him in Winnipeg. He wears fishnet shirts and has stained red hair. Purple on one side, red on the other, I think.
Yeah.
Depends on which day you catch him on.
Depends on how the sun hits him, you know. But he's a real nice guy. Not the kind of person we would walk right up to and say hello, but somebody had told him that we did one of his songs, and this is one of them. It's called Roll Down. It's from a 12-hour folk opera he wrote called The Transports, which was not a big financial success. We think it's because people didn't get to the popcorn like till 6 hours, and they couldn't make it. You know, it was just more than they could take.
Anyway, it has a real simple chorus. And if you all sing, then it'll sound like this anchor is coming up. And it, what it is it's a sort of a rolling story about prisoners in England. They don't have any more room in the prison, so they decide to make them colonists. And they inhabit America, and in this case, New Holland, which is now known as Australia. Sweet ladies of Plymouth, we're saying goodbye. Roll down, we'll rock you and roll you again by and by. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down, and we will roll down. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. Not enough power out there. We're talking calculator battery size power, folks. This anchor's going to be in water for days.
This song only runs to 45 minutes, so you'll have plenty of time to pick up
yeah.
the choruses.
We're talking 325 lyrics.
Unless, of course, you sing. And then it lasts about 3 minutes.
Now the anchor's away, and the sails are unfurled. Roll down, and we're bound for to take her. Halfway around the world, walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. And we will roll down, walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. In the wide Bay of Biscay, the seas will run high. Roll down, and the poor sickly transports will wish they could die. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. And we will roll down, walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. When the wild coast of Africa, it do appear, roll down. The poor nervous transports will tremble with fear. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. And we will roll down. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. When the great southern whales off our quarter do spout, roll down. The poor simple transports will goggle and shout. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. And we will roll down. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. And when we arrive off of New Holland Strand, roll down. The poor weary transports will long for the land. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. And we will roll down. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. And when we set sail for old England shore, roll down. The poor stranded transports will see them no more. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. And we will roll down. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. Sweet ladies of Plymouth, will pay all your rent. Roll down and go roving no more till our money's all spent. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. And we will roll down. Walk around me, brave boys, and roll down. And we will roll down. Walk around me, brave boys.
Very good.
Alas, we have come to the end of our evening.
I'm going to play an air and three reels.
First one is an air of the last reel.
It's a few old reels from Ireland. The first one is called the Kerry Reel. The second one is called the Monaghan Twig. The third one is called She Was Bred in Old Kentucky, but she's only comes up here.
Her words are few, but the choice, don't you think? It's been a pleasure playing for all of you this evening. We've never played in Springfield before, and we would like to come back. So thank you all for coming out. It's really
been fun. Thanks a lot.
I'd like to dedicate this set to a couple of fellows from Springfield, if they don't mind. Gordon McCann, Art Galbraith down here in front. Great players.
everybody. Roger's drum is made of goat skin. And when it gets warm like this, it dries out. And he has to go to the bathroom and put water on it.
It's really fun to watch him use the blow dryer on it, seriously, after he puts water on it. I don't know what they did before modern appliances.
Banjo players know about skin heads.
I'm not saying a word.
There's only one skin head up here.
Thank you. That's all right.
Wait.
That's fine.
Whoa.
We'll play. Well, we played Sunday. We did play Sunday.
Oh,
you don't have one on that.
It busted. I had to take it off and it's got to stretch it.
Tune to G. I might break it.
It'll be an hour or two.
That's a tune, isn't it?
It's closer. Yeah. Ooh.
Close enough for government work.
Can't do it. I got to get mine. I can't do it.
I love the feeling. Let's see.
Well, good to reach your guitar, right? Or do you bring it in here?
What's that?
I don't want to sit here and be the only one. I want people to hear.
We want to hear you.
After you introduce us from the stage, I don't want you to hear how
I
you want us to sing our version of Harry's Get 2 inches? See here, Kissman.
I'll play my little bridge now.
Thank you.
Thank you.
what was the other name for the Seneca Square Dance?
Get out of the way, the Federals.
You know, no.
Yeah. Yeah, we don't play Seneca. I know what you're talking about. Raccoon's tail is ringed all around. Possum's tail is bare. Rabbit don't have no tail at all, just a little bitty bunch of hair. That's what that is. That's what that became.
Play my Beaumont. I don't mean Beaumont. I mean Billy and Lowdown.
Oh, yes.
Well, this is
different. This name.
Thank you.
was this little town out east of Springfield called Stratford, and years and years ago, this doctor brought me into the world, but he was one of these doctors that went to the patient and stayed with it till he's better or dead one, you know. And he was very good at that. He'd go all night there for a baby birth or whatever. And he got his rest in his buggy riding with a driver. He had a colored driver, and he'd drive him to the next patient or back to his home office. And McCraw Ford is a crossing on James River right out east of Springfield here. And it was a tricky crossing. You had pretty well to know how to get there, or you'd just drive off in a deep hole of water, what you'd do. You had to go in a circle around it. But anyway, the buggy lurched when the driver drove down in there and woke up the doctor. And he said, he didn't fuss at the driver at all. He said, just remind me in the morning to play a fiddle tune that I just dreamed.
Yeah.
And that's supposed to be the tune he dreamed.
Called Brown's Dream, too.
Brown's Dream.
Y'all know Cheeky Pin?
Cheeky Pin, I know what you mean, but I don't play them. Let's see if I can think of some of my...
Waverly, that's a Scottish tune.
You were talking about the Over the Water to Charlie or something.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, see, that embarrasses me, though. See, I've been around these hot shots 50 times, whatever you're going on. All I do is like this. So pay attention to him, not what I'm doing there.
Well, let's play this one first, that. And I'll play that. Let's play Fisher's one. Bye.
Fisher.
Thank you.
night.
See ya.
Take it easy, Dave.
Yeah.
Let's see.
What's that other music? It has Annie in it.
Ragtime?
Yeah, ragtime.
Square dance tunes in the Ozarks. That and Wagner and probably Arkansas Traveler or something like that would be the others. Wagner would be the next one, I think, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I'd play Wagner. I'll play another tune with Wagner called Fat Meat and Dumplings. It's, he got exactly the same progression.
Uh-oh.